Welcome back to UK Infos. Today's topic is network topology. Network based on the architecture. The architecture of a network defines how computers, hardware and software are organized and structured. Networks can be classified into two types. The first one is client-server network and the second one is peer-to-peer network. Client-server network. This is a centralized powerful computer. It is called server. In this network, all the PCs or nodes, is known as clients, are connected to the server. Without the server, we could not access the clients because the server machine controls the network. This network is very expensive to set up. Client-server network. In client-server network, there is a centralized powerful computer called the server, which does all the processing. All the network PCs or nodes in the network, known as clients, are connected to the server. The server machine controls the network. These networks are expensive to set up. Next one, peer-to-peer network. It is another name of peer-to-peer network is P2P network. In this network, no server is needed. All the nodes are working as a client or server. Here is direct connection between the nodes. Peer-to-peer network. In peer-to-peer network or P2P network, there is no server machine. Instead, there is a direct connection between the nodes. This architecture is better for smaller networks and is inexpensive to set up and maintain. Next one is topology. What is topology? Topology means the arrangement of computers. It may be classified according to the arrangement of nodes also. Various topologies are there. The first one is star topology, ring topology, bus topology, mesh topology, and tree topology. Network based in the network topology. The arrangement of computers in a network is called topology. Computer networks may be classified according to the arrangement of the nodes in a network. There are various topologies such as star, ring, bus, mesh, or tree. The first one is star topology. Here, the center one server is needed. All the computers are connected by cables to the central device. This topology is very easy to install, but if the server is fails, we cannot access the clients also. But look at the arrangement of computers. It is look like a star. That's why it's called star topology. In star topology, all the computers are connected by cables to a central device, the server. The server controls all the functions of the network. Computers communicate via the server. This topology is easy to install, but if the server fails, the network is disabled. The server uses a device such as a switch or hub to connect all the computers in the network. Next one is ring topology. Here no server is needed. Instead of server, each machine is working as a server. Each machine or each nodes is connected to other two machines. This network is also easy to install, but if any cable is damaged, means we could not access the remaining networks. We can arrange in the topology in ring order. That's why it's called ring topology. In ring topology, all the computers and other devices are connected to each other in a closed circle. There is no server central machine. Instead, each machine is connected to two other machines. This network is also easy to install, but a failure in any cable or nodes can disrupt the entire network. Third one is bus topology. Here, one single cable is available. This is working as a backbone of the network. This single cable is working as a backbone of this network. In this topology, we can share the peripherals like printers, scanners, so everything we can share. This topology we used for the normal small networks. The requirement of cable is very less, but the entire network is dependent on the bus backbone only. If it is damaged, we could not access the remaining computers. Bus topology. In bus topology, a single cable called the backbone or bus carries all the data. All the computers, printers and other peripherals being shared are connected to the bus. This topology is normally used for small networks. The amount of cabling required is less, but the entire network is dependent on the bus backbone. Next one is mesh topology. Take a look here. All the systems, all the PCs, all the nodes is connected to all other nodes. But only one drawback of this topology, we need more cable to arrange this topology. Mesh topology. In mesh topology, every node on the network is connected to all the other nodes of the network, which makes the network very stable. However, the amount of cabling required is very large. Last one is tree topology. This topology is the combination of bus plus star. This is bus topology and this is star topology. So what is tree topology? The combination of bus and the star topology. But this network is more difficult to set up. Tree topology. Tree topology combines the characteristics of bus and star networks. Groups of star topology networks are formed, which are then connected to a bus backbone cable. This network is more difficult to set up. Thank you.